How to integrate ATS-480 DFB derived function block with EcoStruxure Control Expert. Download EcoStruxure Control Expert General Purpose Library and ATS-480 DTM Library on SE.com. Open Types Library Update. Select General Purpose Library, previously downloaded. Select GPL underscore devices. Select family.dsc. Click on Install Family. Open EcoStruxure Control Expert. Create a new project. Select your PLC. If you want to verify that your library is installed, go to Type Library Manager, Library Libset v15.0, General Purpose Library, and GPL underscore devices. Here is your library, EIOSATS-480. Close the library. Go to Project Settings. Adjust option settings of the project. In the project browser, double-click on PLC Bus. Check and adjust the software version of your PLC. Then, double-click on your PLC's Ethernet ports. Click on Unlock Security. Go to IP Config and set the IP address of the PLC. Validate the modifications. Open the DTM browser. Add the ATS-480 DTM Modbus TCP or Ethernet IP. In this video, we will integrate the DFB with Modbus TCP communication. Double-click on your PLC. If you are connected with Ethernet IP on your PLC, set your computer's IP address. Disable the DHCP parameter of your product. Apply the modifications. Open SoMove. Click on Edit Connection / Scan. Select Modbus IPv6. Click on Scan Network. Click on Quick IP Settings. Set the device name and the IP address of your product. Click on Set to Device and restart your product. This configuration can also be done via your display terminal. Once your product has restarted, go back to Control Expert. Rebuild the project. Set your PLC's address and change Media to TCP/IP. Test the connection. Connect to your PLC and transfer the project to your PLC. Connect to your device. If you have an existing configuration, do a load from device. Open ATS480DTM. Go to Parameters List. Set your I/O profile to ATS480 solution. Set Swap Word Order to Modbus Word Order off. If needed, adjust your application parameters. Click on OK and close your ATS480 DTM. If you want to duplicate your device and configuration, copy/paste your product. The IP address will be incremented and the name changed for your new product. Disconnect from your PLC. Build the project. Connect to your PLC. Transfer the project to your PLC. Double-click on Elementary Variables. Select Device DDT. Do a Store Data to Device. Now you can see the variables generated by the DTM on EcoStruxure Control Expert. Click on Initialize Animation Table. Go to Mast and create a new section to insert a DFB. Add a name and set the language to Functional Block Diagram. Insert the ATS480 DFB with FFB Input Assistant. Link the variable of the DTM with the DFB, input, output, freshness. Link some variables to manage your device. Run, external error. Confirm build application. You can modify the value of your variables. You can send a run command. You can check the value on the output of the DFB. If you have another device, you need to duplicate the DFB and change the name of the variables with a new one. Examples: ATS480_1.RUN or ATS480_1.Outputs. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.